Show me your arm. Show me your arm. Show me your arm.
Show your arm.
Tattoo. The tattoo.
Yeah, hopefully the sun shines here to stay. Anyways, welcome to the Friday Seabrook Sunset Concert Series, sponsored by Hondo of Grace Harbor. We do this every Friday through Labor Day, 6 to 8 p.m. And this is our fourth week we've done it, and this is the first time we've been able to have it outside, which is great. But anyways, we're super happy to have you guys here with us. And want to thank Seabrook for making this happen. And also want to thank our great sponsor, Hondo of Grace Harbor, for making it happen too. Give them a round of applause. Hondo of Grace Harbor, we don't sell cars, we help people buy them. Thank you. And without further ado, I give to you Johnny and the Bad Boys.
We're going up, we're going down, we're going up, down, and when you want it, it rolls. Yeah. You got to do what you want, baby, what you want me to do. You got me spinning, you got me hot, you got me spin. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Duncan with North Beach Community TV and NorthBeachNow.com. We are here at the 2022 Sand and Sawdust Festival here in Ocean Shores, Washington. This is the, I guess you could say, the carving part of the section. And we have some world-class wood carving here going on, and it's going to be lots of fun. We're going to check it out. We're here at the 2022 Sand and Sawdust with my good friend Anthony Robinson. You could say that he is one of the most talented wood carvers that I know of.
Thank you, Duncan. Thank you.
A lot of carvers in this area, man.
Thank you.
And some would even say, including myself, that we would consider you like triple OG, grandfather here of wood carvings.
Right on. Thank you for all the compliments. I just like to lead by example. You know, we have young ones coming into this game all the time, and we're also looking to level up from a generation ago, you know, bring a more professional, more dynamic and competitive show. This show here, Ocean Shore, Sand and Sawdust, this is one of along the last few weeks. We have a tour. I've been in Montana, Ronan, Montana. I've been down in Reedsport, Oregon, our divisional championship. This is one of our stops, and then on to Cedro Woolley and Ocean City, 4th of July. Both events are going on simultaneously, but this one brings a lot of the good guys from Washington, Oregon, even California. I don't think we got anybody from Montana this time, but yeah, we've got a good collection of chainsaw artists here this weekend.
And can you briefly describe what goes on at these contests?
Sure enough. So at this particular contest, we are to do three pieces a day, including our main piece that's going to be for the whole weekend. So we have what we call two standard carvings and one quick carve. And so it basically 24 carvers, three carvings a piece. It rapidly increases the amount of auction display people get to bid on. And of course, this is a place to buy your artwork if you're just getting into this, is at these auctions. It also kind of sits what's competitive and what we do, what's a favorite, a crowd favorite. Sometimes it'll be a sea creature, sometimes it'll be animals. It just depends. It's kind of funny to watch what's a crowd favorite.
Gotcha. Speaking of crowd favorite, I know one of my favorites, I know you know what I'm going to say. One of my favorites, personal favorites, is a Sasquatch.
Right.
I know that you've honed your skills on the Sasquatch. How many Sasquatches do you think that you've done up to this point?
Man, I couldn't even tell you, Duncan. It must be so many. I probably have like 500, 600, 700. I don't even know, man. Yeah, it's a lot. It's a lot. Yes.
Well, great. I appreciate you taking some time out to talk with us and share that information. And where are you going to be next?
Like I said, this coming weekend, 4th of July, we'll be at Ocean City for the Ocean City 4th of July chainsaw carving event there.
Absolutely. Well, thank you for your time again.
Thank you.
I look forward to seeing you there.
Thank you, guys.
down at the beach for the sandcastle competition part of the Sand and Sawdust competition. And here we have with us, what's your name, sir?
Jim Butler.
All right. And where are you guys from here?
I'm from Olympia, Washington.
Nice. And how long would something like this take, would you say, for you guys?
4 hours to do it.
That's so really good.
Yeah, thank
That's
you.
Really good. Well, nice to meet you, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
So I'm standing here with Elizabeth Glenn, sculpture artist. Tell me a little bit about where you're from, first of all.
I'm from Lacey, and I'm with the Form Finders team.
Oh, nice. Yeah. And can you tell me a little bit about your art sculpture here?
So they let us know around 11:30 that they had extra clocks to fill, so they moved a couple of us over and told us just to build something, and so I decided to do Stonehenge today.
Nice. It looks like you know what you're doing.
I have a picture.
The pictures tell it all.
It's sort of accurate, hopefully pretty close.
And how much more time do you guys have? You
know? I think like 2 minutes.
Okay, I won't take up any more of your time. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
It's right or it's wrong. about your revolution. It's Independence Day.
And welcome to the beach. My name is Kara McDermott. I'm with the Ocean Shores Fire Department, and I just wanted to welcome you to a great 4th of July weekend. This is a big moment for us, a huge celebration, and we want to make sure that all of our visitors and our residents have a fun and safe weekend. So, as you know, we allow fireworks on July 2nd and 3rd between noon and 11 p.m. And on the 4th of July, which is a Monday this year, we'll allow them from noon to midnight. Now, you can only set them off on the beach between the Damon Road approach, which is right by the Best Western, down to Taurus. And make sure the biggest thing, stay 100 feet away from our dunes. It's dry grass and fires happen very quickly out there. We put out little flags on the beach so that you can know where 100 feet is. Please just recognize those, leave them alone, and make sure you're staying on the water side of those flags at all times if you have fires. That includes sparklers, campfires, fireworks, all that needs to be 100 feet away from the dunes. Now, all that action is happening on the beach, right? When you're in town, there's no fireworks allowed. No sparklers, no firecrackers, nothing. We have these big bright signs now around town that you'll say no fireworks. We ask that you honor that, please, and just keep your fun to the beach. If you're wondering what fireworks are legal or not, please check out Washington State Patrol's website. It's very easy. They have picture guides and tips on how to safely fire fireworks and buy fireworks. Now, a big feature of Ocean Shores is we have a lot of water. We have ocean, we have canals, we have lakes. It's a lot of places to have fun, but we want you to be safe too. Please be aware that we do not have a surf rescue team here. The closest Coast Guard we have is in Westport, and they have limited access. So we need you to be your first and best rescuer. That means do not go in the water unless you are a strong swimmer. We have rip currents out here. The water is very cold and the waves can easily overtake folks. If you have small ones, please make sure they stay within an arm's reach of you. Be right there with them as they play and splash in the water. Keep a weather eye out for all your family members and all your friends. Things can happen very quickly out here. We do not have lifeguards on the beach, so we're counting on you to help keep yourself safe and your family members as well. Personal flotation devices are a great idea. Highly recommend it. But once again, the water is pretty tough out here. If you're not a strong swimmer, a strong ocean swimmer, we ask that you stay out of the water and build a sandcastle instead. We really are looking forward to welcoming everyone to Ocean Shores this weekend. We hope you have a great time. You stay safe. We'd love to wave at you as we go by. You'll see us patrolling and out in numbers. And we hope that you have a wonderful Independence Day.
Thank you. So, obviously, the cleaning up the beach is one of my big things that we want to do, and I'm so grateful of all the people that have volunteered to do this, and we've got them at each beach approach, and the people that are coming in and they're picking up the bags, they're just so grateful that we're actually doing it, and I'm looking forward to what our results are tomorrow with it, and again, I can't thank all the volunteers that were out here handing out the bags through this weekend.
This generally is the most congested area because when people come here, they come right out to the Shiloh, right on the Chance approach, and they set up shop immediately. So everybody kind of, this area is busy with a lot of activity all night long. So we've been on, so far today, two surf rescue incidents, one where we had multiple victims in the water, four or five. And then I just came across the gal who they pulled out, standards pulled out, and I just wanted to talk to her. We have Cert here with their first aid tent set up. They're a huge help. There's the Hulk right there.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Johnny Gargano, and I am proud to present to you Ocean Shores Got Talent. And boy, do we have talent in this area. On behalf of North Beach Community TV, YouTube channel, and Coast Communications Channel 68, we bring Ocean Shores Got Talent. And I know that you're going to love this show because we're featuring local artists that are performing original music. original music, original songs, original arrangements, everything original here. So you're seeing it for the first time right here on our show.
So cool on the surface, and there's a storm and she's brewing down below, and she's starting to blow. Now you built your castle on fall asleep, and your foundation, it's beginning to shake. Lies were your first mistake. Does this burn no prophecy for telling you're the chosen one? You have good to deserve how you have been gifted. To decide, pull your head out and re-examine everything you think you know. Maybe then you grow up, and the next time you choose all the bricks and mortar to rebuild what's left of you, try building with the whole truth. Does it bend a prophecy for telling you're the chosen one? You're good to deserve how you have been gifted.
everybody. It's Stephanie Morton with North Beach Community TV and NorthBeachNow.com. We're here at the Ocean Shores Public Library celebrating 50 years. Let's take a look.
I got this from the governing board. Get it? Governing? They're great. You're going to hear about it. Welcome, and thank you all for coming on such a kind of a yucky day, but if the sun was out, it'd be really hot, folks. So I would like to say good afternoon. Welcome to the 50th anniversary celebration of the wonderful Ocean Shores Public Library. So, question of the day for all of you. Where were you in 72? Some of you don't even know. Way back. Well, 50 years ago, this month, this library was created. So to celebrate those 50 years and this wonderful library today in 2022, there are displays and fun information throughout the library, almost on every corner.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. This is Jeff Moyer, and I'm with the North Beach Senior Center and the Ocean Shores Lions Club. Today's an exciting day. We're here at the Ocean Shores Lions Club for our Project Connect event. We do this once a quarter, and we have the launch of our MAV unit, Mobile Assist Van. We will be going out to remote areas in Grace Harbor County and offering services to those that need. We will have food on the van and a plethora of information for people that might need various services. Today we have approximately 20 vendors inside that are offering services to those that need. We are also have a vaccination clinic going on, and a lot of activity today. But the main thing is the MAV, the Mobile Assist Unit, and that is through a grant that the Senior Center obtained from O3A, Agency for the Aging. So that's what's going on today.
Hi there, I'm Christina, and I've been helpful in setting up the MAV. I will also be driving it out to the rural areas. We don't have a schedule yet, but we are getting one put together. If you would like any more information on it, you can contact us at o3a.org/MAV for the schedule of events as they come up. Or our phone number is 564-212-0662, or you can find us on Facebook under MAV. We look forward to seeing you and bringing resources and services to your town.
Thank you. Will you all give a round of applause for the 5th and 6th graders doing that? 5th and 6th graders, please take your bows now. And 5 and 6 years old, take your bows.
Yeah, just as long as it's not this.
There's no bears tonight.
As long as it's not the big, heavy one.
Okay, you guys can go in.
See you guys in there?
Yep.
One or two.
I got her.
Don't you have anybody lifting her?
No.
Family and friends, our bride has now joined her groom, and we are here to witness their hand fasting and another ceremony that they picked out. So, Jaden Jr., if you will, take your right hand. That's right. And look deep into each other's eyes. Now that you're holding hands, take a moment so that you may see the gift that you are to each other. These are the hands of your best friend.
These hands are holding each other's on your wedding day. As you promise to love each other today, it's harder with my ring. Tomorrow, grandchildren. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future from your eyes, both in sorrow and in joy. These are the hands that will give you support and encouragement to chase down your dreams. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. These are the hands that will lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into eyes that are filled with overwhelming for you. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and old and aged will be reaching for yours and still be giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. We're going to bring your past, your present, and your future together right here. Going to have you each take your left hand, and as you pull your knot together, let go with your right hand. And here we go, folks. Jade and Junior have tied the knot. They have one more ceremony they'd like to do here. And this is jumping the broom. And there are several aspects to this. We're going to focus on them working together in life for this ceremony. Today, we honor and celebrate the transition of two separate lives into one, united by love. We place a broom for jumping, which symbolizes the entrance of the couple into a new life together. Sharing a life with another person requires many leaps of faith. The leap that they take together over the broom is also symbolic. By taking this leap, they make a gesture of dedication by working together through tough times as well as easy times. They leave behind the past and they jump into the future together, secure in their love. Everyone, we're going to do a countdown. We're going to go 3, 2, 1, jump. And when we do that all together, they're going to jump over the broom and we're going to holler and hoot and clap, okay? So, ready? 3, 2, 1,
jump!
Woo!
Woo!
Now, our bride and groom are going to make their way down the path. They're going to take some pictures. Would you guys be so kind as to gather up some tea lights?
Already been too rough, buddy.
No.
And then we're going to head over.
The night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light you see. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't shed a tear just as long as you stand by me. You're in trouble, won't you stand by me? Oh.
makes me feel. Just one more time.